Thank you. yours is the day, O God, yours also the night. You established the moon and the sun. You fixed all the boundaries of the earth. You made both summer and winter. If I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turn to night, darkness is not dark to you, O Lord. The night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Dear friends in Christ, here in the presence of Almighty God, let us kneel in silence and with penitent and obedient hearts confess our sins, that we may obtain forgiveness by his infinite goodness and mercy. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord,
make speed
to
Amen.
reading from the book of Hosea. Yet I have been the Lord your God ever since the land of Egypt. You know no God but me, and besides me there is no Savior. It was I who fed you in the wilderness, in the land of drought. When I fed them, they were satisfied. They were satisfied, and their heart was proud. Therefore, they forgot me. So I will become like a lion to them. Like a leopard, I will lurk beside the way. I will fall upon them like a bear robbed of her cubs, and will tear open the covering of their heart. There I will devour them like a lion, as a wild animal would mangle them. I will destroy you, O Israel. Who can help you? Where now is your king, that he may save you? Where in all your cities are your rulers, of whom you said, "Give me a king and rulers"? I gave you a king in my anger, and I took him away in my wrath. Ephraim's iniquity is bound up. His sin is kept in store. The pangs of childbirth come for him, but he is an unwise son, for at the proper time he does not present himself at the mouth of the womb. Shall I ransom them from the power of Sheol? Shall I redeem them from death? O death, where are your plagues? O Sheol, where is your destruction? Compassion is hidden from my eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Yet among the mature we do speak wisdom, though it is not a wisdom of the age of the rulers of this age, who are doomed to perish. But we speak God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which God decreed before the ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what no eye has seen, no ear heard, nor the human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him, these things God has revealed to us through the Spirit. For the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. For what human being knows what is truly human except the human spirit that is within? So also no one comprehends what is truly God's except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit that is from God, so that we may understand the gifts bestowed on us by God. And we speak of those things in words not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual things to those who are spiritual. Those who are unspiritual do not receive the gifts of God's Spirit, for they are foolishness to them, for they are unable to understand them because they are discerned spiritually. Those who are spiritual discern all things, for they are themselves subject to no one else's scrutiny. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. believe in God, the Father Almighty, with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For all you have saved,
Lord, keep this nation under your care. Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving power among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Lord, the whole of the Lord is taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those things for which we are not worthy to ask. Except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works. Give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Savior. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another your abounding grace may increase among us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
those to be installed as canons will now be presented.
I present Ted Albert, Brian Blair, and Brooklyn Taylor to be installed as a canon to this cathedral.
And I present David Petrow, Julie Murray, Jason Oden, and Michael Spencer to be installed as canons of the Diocese of Southern Ohio.
Do you believe that they are well qualified and duly prepared for this ministry?
I do.
Do you, in the presence of this congregation, commit yourself to this new trust and responsibility?
I do.
Will you who witness this new beginning support and uphold these persons in their ministries? Let us pray for these persons who are to take on the trust and responsibility of a canon. O God, we praise you for the redemption of the world through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. We thank you for pouring out your Spirit upon us to equip your people for the building up of the body of Christ. Bless the work of these canons that they may glorify your name now and forever. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
I'd just like to welcome you all into the warm embrace of the cathedral and to just welcome our bishop with us. It's always a joy to have the bishop here, as it serves as a wonderful reminder to us of our shared life and our shared ministry and our witness, as well as to welcome these new canons into our shared work. I look forward to our continued work together, and I'm excited for what God is doing in this diocese as we enter this new chapter together. As we celebrate their new ministry among us, well, not so new ministry, we'd like just to welcome and invite all of you to join us for some fellowship in our Swan reception area right over here, just a light reception. And if you do go out to dinner with the canons after this, it is the rule that they have to pay for it. So enjoy. Welcome to all.
Let us bless the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.